Okay, let's get rolling. Okay, so first thing we want to do is get into, let me show you how to turn on the symmetry. So you want to go up to Photoshop, CC, scroll down, go to Preferences, and get to Technology Previews. Let's go ahead and dial that up. Next thing we want to do is hit Enable Paint Symmetry. This is what's going to allow this to show on the toolbar. So let's go ahead and click on that, click OK. Now, if you look up top, we now have a butterfly, okay? Butterfly is pretty, right? So we got this butterfly, and this is basically our symmetry. In order to turn this on, we need to come to one of these presets. So let's just go ahead and click on New Vertical. And what you're gonna see is gonna drop down what essentially is a path, but we'll talk about that in a little bit. So it's a path, we can rotate this and turn it into any direction we want, but I'm gonna leave it as is. I'm gonna go ahead and hit return or this checkbox right here to set it. Now that it's set, we have our brush, and what you're gonna see is we're gonna start to get the symmetrical aspects of when we're drawing. It's gonna mirror on both sides. The beauty of this is that you can also turn on your smoothing of your brush, and it'll allow you to get more smoothed out algorithms for the symmetry. Now, this is going to be useful for anyone who's doing decorative artwork, also for people who are doing symmetrical elevation drawings for buildings and concept art, also symmetrical faces. It's not going to be something that you would use for perspective. If you click up here and you scroll through, you can see we have new horizontal. Now, each time you go through one of those lists, it's going to ask you to transform or to commit to the new path that's set up. So you'll see there's a bunch of them in here. Let's jump down to, let's do wavy. Let's talk about this one for a second, okay? All right, so when you're looking at the wavy line and you have the symmetry on, I want you to see that it's not creating a guide where you're forced to adhere to it. What it's doing is you can draw however you want on the other side, but it's going to give you a different aspect ratio to the other side because it's not a straight line. Because there's a slight curve, you're gonna get different effects with the symmetry. Now, let's go ahead and clear this one out. Let's go back in here. And we have new circle, okay. Hit return. Okay, so look what it's doing. It's drawing on the outside, but it's also drawing on the inside. If I draw on the center here, you can see that it's gonna mirror on the outside. So the key point to recognize, whenever you have a path, it's gonna show on the inside and outside when you're doing it. Now, let's go ahead and clear this. Now, what happens if we draw on the inside here and draw a little cleaner? What happens if we do a little wavy line like this? See how it's mirroring on the outside. Okay. And one more. Okay. So that's essentially the mirroring tool. Now let's go in here. I'm going to show you the new dual axis. Let's hit return. If you hold shift, it's going to allow you to constrain your lines as you're doing the symmetry. This will allow you to draw interesting geometric forms. Now, what is this down here? Okay, let's talk about this. Transform symmetry. If we do this, what it basically will allow us to do is come back to that bounding box that we had previously. If you go to the outer edges, it's just like transformation. If I come in here and rotate it, hit return, now what you're gonna see is that it's going to give me the symmetry based off of the new angle relationship that we have. Another important aspect to see is that you can also hide the preview of the symmetry. Okay, so we know it's there, but you can hide the preview so when you're drawing, obstructing your view. Now, it's up to you. Personally, I think it's more useful to have it on. So for me, I would definitely keep that on. Now, let's talk about this last little thing that's dimmed out here, selected path. this is one of the key things I really wanted to talk about, because I haven't seen anyone talk about this yet. How do we get this to activate? So let's go ahead and clear this. Okay, so if we come over here, you have two ways to do this. You can go to your pen tool, and notice up here on the top, I have it set to path, okay? We can also come down to the shape tool, and we wanna make sure this is set to path. We have shape, path, pixels. We need to have path selected, okay? If I draw this shape, it's activated. If I now go back to the brush tool, what you're gonna see is when I have the mirroring tool and I come down to the bottom where it says selected path, this is going to be the new symmetry shape that we're gonna be using. If we hit return, what you're gonna see is now it's doing everything that we saw before, and it's going to draw on the inside and outside of that path. The key takeaway is you can make a path, whether it's drawn with the pen tool, or you can use the shapes that are inside of here are at your disposal for using for symmetry. And let me show you one last thing before we get out of here. If we go over to the paths palette, you're gonna see every single path that we've been using for the symmetry is inside of here. So it goes back to show that every single thing that we've been using is essentially a path. Okay, there you have it. The new symmetry for the Adobe Photoshop CC 2018. If you found this video helpful in any way, please don't hesitate to subscribe if you haven't done it already. Until next time, this is Robert Revels for Digital Painting Tips. Out.